And we're back! Sorry about the little break, everybody. I need to go ahead and eat, shower, get everything pretty much just ready to, for bed tonight. So, I don't know how long we'll be going, but we will be going a lot longer. Well, not as long as we did before, holy crap. We actually did record for 5 hours straight. But right now, we are trying to track down the armory, or how to at least get to the armory. Which is probably somewhere on the wall. Let's run along the wall. We did sleep. We fast traveled to get back here. Okay, there has to be a way up. Okay, there has to be a way up here. Close enough. I'm guessing the armory is this way. We will find out.
What's the matter, man? Meet the ship.
Okay, that's kind of funny. Teabagging people think you have to shit. Okay, can I go up this way? I'm not block picking through that noise. Well, we're getting a wonderful view of the town. I just wish I knew where the hell we were going. Did I just go the opposite direction for no good reason? We are trying to figure this out. Oh god, we're actually at the armory. Hello!
I was told to pick up a kit here.
Name?
Henry.
And? In fealty to?
Sir Radzik Cobbler.
Yes, I've got you. Well, come on in then. Make yourself at home, Henry. If my memory serves me, you're entitled to a helmet, a gambeson, and a cloak.
That's all.
You want a kiss and a hug as well?
I mean,
yes!
That's quite enough for patrolling the town. You're there to stop trouble, not start it.
Okay, let's go ahead and equip all that. I got a helmet! Alright, now we need to head. To the next quest marker. How far away are we from that? Well, we're heading in the right direction.
Never give up! Never surrender! Everyone knows.
That must be a butcher shop. Is this the church? Yeah, this is the church. He's either in, around, or near the church.
And let the perpetual light shine upon you.
Hello.
How does life in Rat-Eye suit you?
It'd be fine if we didn't have to sleep in hovels and beg for alms. And the bailiff is always on our backs, the bastard. But what can we do? We've got nowhere else to go.
Should be a captain or someone waiting for me somewhere. Who are we meeting? Okay, we're gonna go till 10 and then we're gonna stop there. Actually, no, we'll go all the way to 11. The fuck are you bouncing on an egg? Oh god, I poisoned myself.
Here I am. My name is Henry. We're supposed to go on patrol together.
I see you're kitted out.
Ready to get going.
I'm Nightingale. Aren't you that lad the mill wench brought here on a cart?
Teresa. Yes, she rescued me. She turned up with Captain Robot and his knights.
All honor to the girl. She has bigger balls than most men. Tell me, how did you pay her back?
Well, I thanked her.
That's not much, is it? You should go and see her when you get a chance. So how did you end up in the service of the bailiff?
I wanted to enter the service of Sir Radzik, but he sent me here to learn.
And learn you will. You're lucky, lad. Sir Radzik must like you. Most lords would have just sent you on your way.
Come with me, Henry. We'll patrol the town and then check on the taverns to make sure they lock up in the evening.
I'm ready.
Don't forget, I'm supposed to try you out and, with the help of God, teach you something. So I expect you to deal with any misconduct yourself. I'll make sure you don't do anything too stupid. Let's go.
Yay! I got a helmet in the club!
This is our church, St. Matthew's. It serves not only as the house of God, but as the crypt of the Lords of Lyfa, our masters. The gravedigger lives right round the corner. The priest, too. Our parish priest. Ah, a man shouldn't speak ill about servants of the Lord. This is our rat house. Pretty big, eh? The bailiff and his hands live there, and our maestro proto notarius, the scribe. And the jailhouse. You don't want to see the inside. Not even as a guard. Naturally, we have an executioner too, but he doesn't live in town. That wouldn't be proper, as I'm sure you know. He lives by Gallows Hill, the other side of the creek. This pillory was brand new in autumn, and two people have already been rotting on it. The swordsmith was here.
A swordsmith, you say? What's going on?
What are you two screeching about? Stop making such a ruckus.
About time you turned up. This filthy beggar thinks.
My name is Jane.
No one cares what your name is. This filthy beggar thinks she can come and stink in front of my shop. I want you to get rid of her.
Oh.
What's the problem here?
This is my shop, and I won't have beggars sitting on my doorstep. Let her go and squat in the square. She won't be in anyone's way there, and there's plenty of folk to pick from.
Must you sit here, of all places?
Yes, I do.
Why?
Folk drive me away wherever I sit. I can't keep walking all day and night.
Can't you show us some Christian charity, Henri?
What? Have you any idea how much I've given away in alms? Even to this witch only yesterday.
Is that true?
Might be. Might not.
Did you get any arms or not?
Yes.
From the armorer here?
I don't know. And even if I did, that was yesterday, and my belly's empty again today.
That's true.
What would you know about it?
We're both good Christians, aren't we? We should each give something to the poor soul.
And what then?
Then Jane will be on her way. Immediately.
King Solomon now, are you, lad? Fine. Fine, have it your way.
God bless you, and you too, citizen. I won't be a nuisance no more, really. Thank you. Thank you.
Jesus. You're as bad as each other.
Okay, he went that way.
Your old neighbors are living here now. It's a bit of a shithole. Even so, you should be thankful to Sir Hanush. If the town burgers were away, your folk wouldn't be let anywhere near the town. And now our people aren't too happy with him. Some fools are even calling for Sir Hanush to finally hand the fiefdom over to the young lord, Sir Hans Capon. Sir Hans's father, old Sir Yeshke, may God rest his soul, kept it till he was an old man. Then he retired from it, first to Moravia, then to eternity. Sir Hanush is managing the fiefdom until Sir Hans comes of age. They're related by blood somehow, the same great-great-grandfather or some such. The time's coming soon enough when the estates have to be handed over. These affairs often end in conflict. I hope we have nothing like that here.
So far, we've resolved one conflict. What about the other conflicts we've got to deal with?
This square here, it looks much better during the markets. Then it's filled to bursting with folk from all around. We've also got the baker's shop here, and that mad merchant Wolfram Bruder. Bruder has a pretty daughter. Keeps her on a short
day,
which the young bucks are none too happy about. I heard he even keeps the poor lass locked up at home all day.
Aww. Well, in this day and age, that's actually not a bad thing.
There's one alehouse here on the market square, the Trader's Tavern. The other's up by the gate. We'll be going there later.
All right. This is a big town. Much bigger than the little place that we were staying.
See that filthy beggar? By Christ, I'll show the bastard. Comfortable, are we?
Please, sir.
Who do you take me for? Are you stupid or just insolent?
Well, what's the matter?
Stupid, then. There's no begging allowed here, so pick up your stinking arse and haul it somewhere else.
Who am I bothering here?
Me. Us. Everyone. If Sir Hanu saw you here, he'd take a whip to you.
All right, I'm going.
Damn beggars. You offer them a helping hand, and they want the whole arm. It's not like the rules aren't clear. Beggars belong at the church. Here's the forge. The blacksmith has some trouble, and he's not working at the moment, but his apprentice is standing in for him tolerably. I hear you're a blacksmith's apprentice, too. You lot could help if needed, couldn't you?
Us? What do you mean?
You and your master, or your father, whoever taught you.
They...
What is it, lad?
My father was the master blacksmith. He was killed in Skellies.
Ah, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Thank you. So am I.
My papa died not long ago. Of course, it was old age got him. That's not the same, but I know a little how you feel.
I know he's trying to be sensitive. I can actually appreciate that. Because I think he honestly felt like a cunt. Neat. Oh, that music. That makes me wish I had a giant turkey leg. You ought to be glad that I'm not. I'm trying to be a good character. Oh, but if I did not give a shite and I was going evil.
God be with you, Benesh. How goes it?
Well enough, Nightingale. It's quiet today.
Good. Where's Moimir anyway? Isn't he supposed to be here with you?
Yes. He hasn't turned up yet.
Oh, I see. Now, where might he have gone to, then?
I don't know.
You don't know, eh? Let me tell you something. When the bailiff finds out Moimir's slacking off, he'll be in serious shit. And being a friend of his, you wouldn't want that, would you?
No.
So it's better if I deal with it and we leave the bailiff out of it, right?
Yes, I suppose so.
But where is he? Went for an ale. We know how that goes. Come on, Henry. Let's go and find that idler, and you'd better talk some sense into him.
So I get to talk to another godforsaken drunk.
Have a drink.
Okay. Let's drink. Yeah.
as well, the lazy bastard.
My words exactly. And just when we need every pair of eyes. You never know when the humans might creep up on us. But that's enough about that. Let's not let it spoil our day. Listen, since we're sitting here anyway, how about a little game?
Why not?
What are we playing? Are we playing Yahtzee? I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing.
What the hell's with these damn dice?
Ah.
Pushed it.
Hold, 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 hold. We guess bust. Yep.
We'll see.
We'll see. Cursed luck.
All right. I don't know what the fuck is going on, but we're playing this game, and I have no idea what the hell I'm doing.
Cursed luck.
Ow.
Oh.
I seriously do not understand what we're doing.
That's it.
Cursed luck.
I guess you can only get ones and fives. Is it a bust? Oh. Shit. Okay, I now get the point of this game. Kind of. Sort of. Maybe. Save those. Roll for initiative. Ah.
With these damn dice.
Let's see. Aw. We keep rolling a damn three at the last one.
No luck tonight.
There's two. Let's see what we get. This game is not going anywhere. Suck it.
This'll be the one. We'll see.
Shouldn't have pushed it.
Okay, we just need two ones and we can beat them. Are we stuck? Oh, no, 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 no.
Christ be praised.
Did you find out what actually happened?
What do I know? The lords are at each other's throats, but it's us that has to suffer for it, same as always. I reckon they was after the silver mine, wasn't they?
Oh my god, we're gonna have to... Yeah, we'll load from that one and see how far that puts us back. Okay, now it's loading.
Shouldn't we be on patrol instead of drinking?
You're eager, aren't you? Don't worry, even watchmen are entitled to a break. Except the ones on the gate of the tower, of course. But that's enough about that. Let's not let it spoil our day. Listen, since we're sitting here anyway, how about a little game?
Why not?
Let's see if it actually goes through this time. Luckily, now I understand this.
No point in pushing it.
Here, just as you ordered.
So we'll go ahead, roll again. We'll pass and score.
Should I? Shouldn't I? No, I dare.
I got a feeling he's gonna kick our ass this time.
Your turn.
one more thing and we're done for the night. Ringing the end of the day and closing the taverns.
Isn't it still a bit early?
I don't know how it was in Scarlet, but here in Rate we close up at this hour. Except, of course, during fairs and big festivals. Then we don't close at all.
See. Should I go and ring the bell?
If you wouldn't mind, the bell is hanging outside the Rat House. Ring three times, then go to the Trader's Tavern by the Market Square and make sure the innkeeper closes up.
I'll do that.
Before I forget, it's forbidden to walk in Rate at night without a torch. Here, take this one.
Oh, we get a torch! Okay, now how do I... Chip 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 chaps! We gotta figure this out. So we just need to ring the bell. Okay, we're gonna head up. Okay, this is just where the bailiff is. Okay, we still are trying to find where the bell is. Where's an alchemy lab? Where's the tavern we're supposed to go to? Okay, there it is. Ooh, we get a cutscene.
And the canon of St. Wenceslas in Olomouc was so drunk, he dragged the pig to the market square, saddled it up, and rode it out of the town gate! Now we can see that this wasn't going to end well. So, Sir Peter and I rode off to look for the good canon on his pig. Did you find him? We tracked the filthy beast down to a sty beyond Cronau. I mean, the beast with a tonsure on its head. We never found the real pig, but the Reverend was sound asleep in the pigsty.
Birds of a feather stick together. It seems the same goes for pigs and planets. I toast, gentlemen, to pigs and planets.
God save their bacon.
Sir Hans, forgive my intrusion, but I need...
Oh, but what? You want to join us? Want to buy us around? I'm afraid we don't drink with peasants. You're not in your village now, boy.
No, sir. Curfew's been rung. The alehouse is closing.
Nothing closes while I'm sitting here. If that's all, you're dismissed.
Are you out of your mind, lad? You can't cross his lordship. He's got a temper like a bear with gut ache. If I was you, I'd get lost before he shows it.
The bailiff instructed me to close the tavern at the proper hour. He doesn't want anyone disturbing the peace after curfew.
The bailiff? The bailiff can kiss my ass. I trust you haven't forgotten who's the rightful lord of Ratte.
No, it's Sir Hamish.
Oh, is he here? What, is he hiding under the table, maybe? No! Then what he wants isn't worth a fart in a bathhouse. And besides, he's only in charge till I grow up.
Which clearly hasn't happened yet.
Enough! You can't talk to me like that. I'm a nobleman.
Come now, sirs. You're not going to fight here, are you?
We most definitely are. This yokel needs to be taught his place.
Oh, God. We're in so much shit right now.
You'll die for that.
We're about to get in trouble, aren't we?
Crucifix! What in the name of Christ is happening here? Hell, answer me, damn you!
This peasant insulted me. I had to teach him a lesson.
By rolling around in the mud like a hog? That's a fine example of noble conduct.
Sir Hannes, the bailiff ordered me to...
Silence! You shut your mouth and thank your lucky stars that you are Radzig's ward. Have you gone out of your mind, raising your hand to a nobleman? And you, Hans, how many times have I told you that drinking with your subjects might be good for their morale, but it's bad for your honor? You spend all your days drinking and chasing wenches, which wouldn't matter if you paid any attention at all to your duties. And now we see what that leads to. Tomorrow, you will go with me to a hearing. Some landowners have asked me to settle a dispute. It will be an excellent lesson for you.
I had planned to go hunting, but if you think listening to the pointless gripes of a bunch of old fools will benefit me, so be it.
Hunting? Well then, Your Grace, I'll tell you what. You can go hunting.
Really?
Naturally. Who am I to deprive the young Lord Capon of his sport? And You can take Henry here as your page.
Him? Absolutely not.
You'll do as I've commanded. It's time you learned how to lead people, and not just in drinking and brawling. Now get out of my sight.
Sir, I have responsibilities at the bailiff.
Not anymore. Your responsibilities now are the Lord Capon. It's time you learned how to behave in the presence of nobility. Let's go. Tell the kitchen I'm hungry. It's been a long journey.
Did I actually save? Okay, we're gonna have a save and we're actually gonna end the stream right there. I'd like to thank everybody for watching. I hope everyone enjoyed. There might be more of this in the future. We might be a little bit farther in the game. I'm not really wanting to make this a full-on stream. I just wanted to show everybody this game. But as always, I want to thank everybody for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. For updates, follow me on Twitter. I shall see everybody in the next one.